defend yourself, your faith, your people is something that is considered as a dharmic duty. So in that context was what the political Hindutva came up as a bulwark against political Islam, and you know, the attempts by missionaries and so on to convert our people. So I mean, when Swami Vivekananda, I mean, somebody who on his way back, I think from America, in the ship, there is some missionary who is spewing venom on Hindus and Hindu gods and calling them as pagans and so on, as was the case and perhaps still is. So to look down upon the faith, he kept hearing all of this. And at some point he rushed into him, towards him, held him by his collar and said, if you utter one more word against my faith, I'm going to throw you into the ocean. So, you know, that is
Hindutva. That is Swami Vivekananda.
Yeah. That is Hindutva in action, right? That is where Hindutva is showing that I will remain quiet, I will listen to you, but if you go on and on, at some point I am going to resist. So Hindutva, the political arm of Hindutva, and political in today's context, we'll think, oh, it's linked to some party or something, but political would mean something that urges you to stand up. So that arm, which whether it was even Maharishi Aurobindo's writings, never taught, he was very, very critical of Gandhi and his pacifist attitude, that he had almost emasculated the Hindu of any sense of resistance, legitimate resistance for their own rights. And at a time when Muslim separatism was at its peak, and we saw the horrors of partition, we saw Mopla carnages, we saw the Khilafat movement, we saw everything that was happening, despite that, to turn a blind eye to that was suicidal for the Hindus. And we saw that eventual manifestation during partition, Deliverance Day, and all these run-up that happened to the horrors of partition. So in that context is where we see the birth of Hindutva as we talk about it today, as Hinduism that resists.